Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss a new chapter, that is our constitution, and it is your first chapter in civics. Students, in the previous classes I feel you have studied about the constitution. Before we discuss about the constitution, first we will discuss about rules and laws. And what is rules and laws? Family is the basic unit of a society. It comprises of various institutions and organizations at different levels. The smooth functioning of all such units depends upon certain rules and laws which are recognized by a country or a community to regulate the action of its members. Think of what would happen if we all do not follow traffic rules while driving or walking on the road. That's why we must obey the traffic rules when we ride or drive any bike or car. Every individual would feel unsafe if we not carry the rules of traffic. We all need to follow the rules and regulations to regulate our day-to-day life. Rule of law. Rule of law means that every citizen of the country is equal in the eyes of law. Means all are equal in the eyes of law. There is no discrimination on the basis of a caste, religion, sex, social or economic status. Means all people are equal. Everybody is recognized to follow a set of law, be it the people or the government official or the elected representatives of people, means MLA and MP, who form the government. Means all people are equal in the eyes of the law, and each and every people must obey or follow the laws which are prescribed by the government. In fact, rule of law is the basic foundation of a democratic system and the basis of all type of equalities. Therefore, rule of law demands that those who are occupying positions of power should not be allowed to act in an arbitrary or unlawful manner. Means rule of law must follow by each people. Those who are in power, they must follow some rules and laws which are prescribed by the government or by the constitution. On the other hand, the common man should be provided protection by law to enable her or him to enjoy equal rights. The common people also provided some laws, which the laws protect the people to enjoy their rights. But let us not forget the equal rights are not possible without discharging equal responsibility. Then we are going to discuss about the constitution. What is constitution? A constitution is a body of fundamental rules according to which the government of a country functions. Means a set of rules and regulations by which the government govern the country. It contains the power and function of the various organs. In the constitution, The constitution also contains the power and the function of the various organs. You know that there are three organs in the government. The three organs are legislature, executive, and judiciary. Legislature means the MPs and the MLAs, or those who are the elected by the people, means the elected representative, they are the member of a legislature. Executive means the government officers, those who execute the policies or implement the policies prescribed by the government. And they are the government officers. The legislature and the executive, they are interrelated. And the third organ of the government, that is the judiciary. And the mutual relation between the three organs, it also mentioned in the constitution. It also defined the right of the citizens and the relation between the government and its citizen. In each and every country, people or citizen enjoy some rights, and their relation between the citizen and the government. Therefore, in the Indian democratic setup, the constitution is a pivot and the primary source of our laws. It gives a detailed description of fundamental principles on the basis of which the laws are made and the country works. Now we are going to discuss about the need of a constitution and what is the need to form the constitution. India is a vast country with various physical, cultural, and social diversities. In our country, there are so many religions, language, culture, and on the basis of area-wise, a vast country also. Different people belonging to different regions who speak different languages have very different lifestyle. Though different in beliefs and actions, they have many things in common. Yet, they may or may not agree on all the issues. Therefore, the constitution provides a set of rules, principles, and laws acceptable to almost all as the basis of life and governance of the country. Means the constitution provides a set of rules, principles, and laws which are acceptable at the basis of life and governance of the country. Means the government must follow the rules and regulations which are prescribed in the constitution. It is a multi-purpose document which caters to our needs, requirements, future aspiration, and the ideals set before us. To meet these requirements, the constitution serves the following purpose. The constitution set the following purposes. What are the purpose and why we need the constitution? Defines the first purpose of the constitution. The constitution defines the nature of a country's political system. How the government also formed, how the government representatives also elected. This is also defined in the constitution. Then it lays down rules and provide safeguard against misuse of power and abuse of authority. The constitution also provides certain significant guidelines that help in decision making. How the decisions are also taken by the government. Within a democratic setup. And how to safeguard against the misuse of power and abuse the authority of which leads to gross injustice by those in power. and it guarantees rights based on equality to establish social, political, and economic justice. Each and every citizen in our country enjoys some rights. The rights are divided in different kinds of rights. All rights are known as the human rights. Some fundamental rights are also guaranteed to our constitution. Ensure that minority groups are not deprived of the benefits available to the majority group. In our country, on the basis of a minority, that is on the basis of a religion, the minority people are not deprived of the benefit available to the majority group. It ensures that the majority group does not dominate the minority. The constitution also provides that the majority group does not dominate the minorities. The constitution guards our national interest, and it does not allow dictatorial or biased decision which may change the very basic structure of the constitution. The constitution plays a crucial role in democratic societies towards the achievement of a desired goal. These are the purpose of the constitution. And today we also discuss about the first part of the constitution, and the next period, by next class, we will discuss the second part of the constitution. Thank you and have a good day.